today. Why don't you shake a hand to the person that's in front of you, behind you, on the left side of you, on the right side of you, if you don't have anyone. On any side of you, you're not in the sanctuary. Praise the name of the Lord today. Praise the name of the Lord. Smile at somebody. Amen, amen. Praise the Lord. How many is ready to worship Jesus today? Amen. You come in here to worship the Lord today, to be in His presence. Man, we realize that when we begin to worship Jesus, when our praises go up, God begins to send something powerful to come down today. How many expects God to do something in this house? You come in expecting God to do something in this house. Amen. That's what church is about. Amen. We come into the house of God, and God begins to bless His people today. Amen. I want us all across the sanctuary, from the platform to the sound booth, even those that are out in the lobby, I want you to begin to lift up your hands right now and begin to bless the name of the Lord right now. Come on, open up your mouth. Begin to talk to Him. Jesus, thank You, Lord, so much for loving me. That's it. That's it, church. Begin to praise Him. Begin to magnify Him. Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah. We worship You, God. Hallelujah, Jesus. Hallelujah, hallelujah. We praise You. Come on, church. A little bit deeper now, a little bit deeper. Come on, let it come from your heart. Let it come from your heart right now. Jesus, I really do love You. I really do praise You, God. I really do magnify You, Lord. Thank You, Jesus, for loving me so much, Lord. Hallelujah.
There is nothing worth more that will ever come close. Nothing can compare. You're our living hope. In Your presence, Lord. Oh. And I've tasted and seen of the sweetest of the loves, where my heart becomes free and my shame is undone. Oh, Your presence, Lord. Holy Spirit.
Glory, God, is what our hearts long for, to be Your.
Lord, for he's a great king, he's doing great things. My soul says yes, yes, yes to the Lord.
My soul says yes, yes to the Lord.
My soul says yes to the Lord.
For He is a great King.
He's doing
great things.
Oh, my
soul.
My soul says yes, yes, yes to the Lord.
He brought me out.
He brought me out of darkness to His marvelous light. He set my feet on straight street and now I'm doing right.
For He's a great King.
He's doing great things. My soul says yes, yes. Light. He set my feet on straight street and now I'm doing right. Lord, He's a great King. He's doing great things. My soul says yes, yes, yes to the Lord.
My soul says yes to the Lord.
My soul says yes to the Lord. For He's a great King. He's doing great things. My soul says yes, yes, yes to the Lord. Yes to the Lord, for He's a great King. He's doing great things. My soul says yes, yes, yes to the Lord.
He brought me out.
He brought me out of darkness into His marvelous light. He set my feet on straight street and now I'm doing right.
For He's a great King.
He's doing great things. My soul says yes, yes, yes to the Lord. Great things. My soul says yes, yes, yes to the Lord.
My soul says yes to the Lord.
My soul says yes to the Lord. For He's a great King. He's doing great things. My soul says yes, yes, yes to the Lord.
Hallelujah, let's worship Him right now. Thank You, Jesus. Thank You, Jesus. My soul says yes.
Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah. Amen. Won't you turn to your neighbor and tell your neighbor, you should have known me before I met Jesus. Turn to your other neighbor and say, if you would have only known me before I met the Lord, you wouldn't know who you're sitting next to today. Why? Because God brought me out of darkness and placed me into His marvelous light. I believe someone's got a reason to praise Him today. Someone's got a reason to lift up the name of Jesus in this house. Hallelujah. Yeah. Hallelujah. Oh, He brought me out of darkness into this marvelous light. He set my feet on straight street and now I'm doing right.
He's the great King.
Oh, He's doing great things.
Oh, my soul says yes, yes, yes to the Lord.
Oh, my soul said yes
to the Lord.
Oh, my soul said yes
to the Lord.
Oh,
He's the great King. He's doing great things.
Oh, my soul says yes, yes, yes
to the Lord.
Oh, He gave me a song the angels cannot sing. But glory, hallelujah,
I have been redeemed.
He's the great King.
He's doing great things.
Oh, my soul said yes.
Yes to the Lord.
Oh, for He's the great King.
He's doing great things. My soul says yes, yes, yes to the Lord.
Hallelujah. Come on, praise. Praise and praise and praise and praise and praise. Hallelujah, hallelujah, Jesus. Amen, 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 amen. God is in the house. God is in the house today. Amen. Before we go further, I'd like for you, a few of our brothers together on Brother Fritz, just put your hand on his back. A few of our sisters, Grand Sister Bennett, that are close by, we're going to pray over them today. God is already working. He's already working. Amen. But we just believe in the prayers of the saints, the prayers of the saints right now. Hallelujah. Church, could you help me pray? In the name of Jesus, we pray right now. Hallelujah. Oh, God, we plead the blood of Jesus. We plead the blood of the risen Lamb, God, upon their bodies. God, begin to heal. In the name Jesus. In the name Jesus, there is all power and authority. In the name Jesus. God, you made our bodies. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. You created our bodies. In the matchless name of Jesus, right now, God, begin to do a blood transfusion. God, your blood for theirs. Yes, hallelujah, hallelujah. By your stripes, we are healed. I'm claiming my healing in the name Jesus. I am claiming this healing in the name of the Lord. Yes, my soul says yes. My faith says yes. I am claiming my breakthrough. I am claiming my healing. There is no power but in the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Come on, could we rejoice? Could we rejoice with our sister and our brother right now? Come on now. Praise God for what he just did in faith. In faith. Hallelujah. In faith we believe. In faith, God, we claim. We proclaim our miracle in the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. Let me just take a moment time. Could I have some sisters go and pray with Sister Natalie in the back? She's been having some pain in her body. Hallelujah. Come on, some sisters. Come on. We ain't got enough room in the front, so let's just turn the whole sanctuary. Hallelujah. The presence of God is here. Let's just begin to, come on, pray, pray, pray. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. In the name of Jesus right now. Begin to touch her body right now in the name of Jesus. God, let your spirit, God, begin to arise right now in the name of Jesus. Begin to touch her body. Oh, God, we apply the name of Jesus. We apply, God, the blood of Calvary. We apply, Lord, by your stripes, we are healed in the name of Jesus. God, I'm not leaving without my healing. I am not leaving without my breakthrough. God, I'm not going to wake up tomorrow morning with pain. God, I'm waking up tomorrow morning with promise. I'm waking up today with praise. Yes, yes, in the name of Jesus we pray. Come on, church, let's give the Lord a hand clap of praise. Praise the name of Jesus today. How many knows that we serve an almighty healing God? Amen. Our God's a healer. Our God is a healer today. We are proclaiming his healing in this church today. How many loves Jesus today? You wouldn't be here if you didn't love Jesus today. And so we are expecting God to do great things. Amen. You may be seated. Brother Jason is coming up at this time. We've got all kinds of great things coming up. Please be mindful of these announcements.
Praise the Lord, everyone. Amen. First one, the youth group is having their youth camp is next week. It's Thursday, Friday, and Saturday. And after service today, they're going to be having a meeting. So if you're going to youth camp, please attend that meeting right after service. The Golden Pillars are having their lunch fellowship today. It's going to be at El Camino in Greenville. So keep that in mind if you're in the Golden Pillars group. And the Singles Fellowship, they're going to be meeting next Sunday after service. They're going to lunch at Vent's restaurant in Greenville. So keep that in mind if you're a single. Anyone is invited for that. The Dark County Fair is coming up, and we are adding to our stockpile of poppets in the kitchen. You may think that's a lot of poppets in the kitchen, but that might last us maybe one day. One day. So if you can please donate some pop for that, all the ingredients that we need or the flavors that we need are in the bulletin, so keep that in mind for the fair. And also, La Comunidad Dinner Theater is coming up. It's going to be on Sunday, September 20th. There is a sign-up sheet on the back bulletin board. If you're interested in that, please sign up for that event. At this time, we're going to take up our Sunday morning tithe and offering. And have Brother Michael Shell say the prayer this morning.
We're stirring up deep, deep waters. We're gonna jump in the river. Jump in the river. Deep cries out to deep cries out to you. Deep cries out, deep cries out to you. We cry out to you, Jesus. Deep cries out to deep cries out to you. Deep cries out to you. We cry out. We cry out to you, Jesus. We're falling into deeper waters, calling out to you.
Oh, we're walking, yes, into deeper
waters.
We're
going after.
Oh, yes, put your hands together. If he goes to the left, then we'll go to the left. And if he goes to the right, then we'll go to the right. We're gonna jump, 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 jump in the river. Jump, 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 everybody. If he goes to the left, then we'll go to the left. And if he goes to the right, then we'll go to the right. We're gonna dance, 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 dance in the river. Dance, 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 everybody. If he goes to the left, then we'll go to the left. And if he goes to the right, then we'll go to the right. We're gonna jump, 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 jump in the river. Jump, 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 everybody. If he goes to the left, then we'll go to the left. If he goes to the right, then we'll go to the right. We're gonna shout, 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 shout in the river. Shout, 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 shout. Let your soul cry out to him right now. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah.
Praise the Lord. Give him one more hand clap of praise today. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Jesus. Praise the name of the Lord today. If you are a visitor, and this is your first time here today, amen, we'd like to welcome you to Solid Rock Apostolic Church. Church, could you join with me now in welcoming them? Thank you for coming. Thank you for coming. If there's anything that we can do to be a blessing to you, please, please let us know. We'd like to get to know you and get to meet you. I believe that God is doing a great work in Bradford, Ohio. Do you believe that today? Amen. Amen. We give God all praise and glory and honor. Amen. For it is him who has made us and not we ourselves. It is God. And God only do we serve and give glory for. It's so good to see Brother Sister Cummings here today. So glad that you're here with us as well. Could you give them a hand as well? Amen. Thank you for being with us. Amen. Amen. Man, we got a preacher in the house today. I'm so excited. Amen. For Brother Jordan and Sister Lindsay and their little bundle of joy. Their little bundle of joy. Amen. We have got a beautiful, beautiful baby. And God has blessed them greatly. God has blessed them greatly. And we're excited that they're here with us today. Did you know that you're made free by the word of the Lord? You need the word in this house today. And I'm going to tell you how I feel before he comes. I prayed before church today, God, there's a word that I need to hear today. There's a word that I need to hear. How many need something from God today? Come on, raise your hand. I'm not too proud to admit that. Need something from God today. I believe with all of my heart that God is going to use Brother Stumbo to give you the word that you are seeking after today. God is going to use this ministry to give you that word today. If we could all stand all across the congregation, hallelujah. Could you raise your hands right now? Jesus, God, Lord, I pray that the anointing of God would sit upon Brother Stumbo today, God. Oh, Jesus, right now, God, as I pray, Lord, that you'd use this ministry, God, to help us, God. Oh, God, someone in this room today searching for an answer, God, I pray. I know, God, that you've got the messenger, God, with the message, God, for this mess age. God, you're going to help us, God, and you're going to loose, God, someone in this house today. God, you are going to loose depression in this house today. You are going to loose someone, God, that came in struggling and hurting today. You're going to do something powerful and mighty today. Could you give the Lord and Brother Stambo a hand as he comes today?
Amen. Let's give it all to the Lord today. Hallelujah. Lord, you're worthy. Lord, you're holy. Amen. 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 Thank you, Jesus. Bless the Lord. Hallelujah. I would just real quick, before I have you sit down, as of the level of your expectation today, can you give the Lord one more praise? Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Lord, I believe in you, oh God. I believe in you, oh God. I believe in you, oh God. Oh, show you. Amen, amen. You may be seated today in this house. Amen. Isn't God good? Amen. If he doesn't do one more thing, he's already been good to me. Amen? But he's not done. He's not done. Amen. And Brother O'Shea, before service, told me, I said, you don't have to introduce yourself. But, you know, brother, there are so many new people. I just noticed, I was like, well, I thought I knew everybody. And I thought everybody knew me, but that's just a wonderful thing. God's bringing people who have a desire to love him together. Amen? And I mean, it's wonderful to see so many new faces and so many faces I've known for years. Amen. My name is Jordan Stumbo. I'm a missionary to Russia and the Baltic states. I grew up there from whenever I was 9 years old until I was 18, came back to the States. And I met my lovely wife, Lindsay, and we moved back over to St. Petersburg about 3 years ago. Been living there ever since, planning works, doing Bible studies, and just doing whatever we can to expand the kingdom of God. Amen. And God is good. He's working. Amen. I do feel an expectation in my spirit today. I do feel that God is going to do something. And he's going to do it because he loves his church. He loves you. I appreciate Brother O'Shea's word already today. He just loves you. Doesn't condemn you. He loves you. And by that love, he is willing to do amazing things. Faith worketh by love. Amen. But today I want to talk to you, to somebody that may be hurting. Maybe you're worried. I get worried sometimes. I think, well, God, I don't understand what's going on in the world. I don't understand what I see, what I read in the news. I mean, there's Christians being beheaded all over the world. My God. Things are happening in this nation we never thought we would ever see. And on many fronts, the church seems to be losing ground. And we think, God, if the church is losing ground, where can I find hope? I'm just being honest, church. Today, I want to give you a message of encouragement. And I won't keep you long today, but I feel that the Lord wants to speak to some broken hearts and some people that need some mending in their lives. If you will allow God to speak through you today, he's going to do something. He's going to do something. If you'll just allow him to work. In the name of Jesus, we come before you one more time, Lord. We come before you with needs, Lord. But we've come to worship you in our needs, to praise you in our pain, in our hurt. Lord, honor our worship and our praise and our faith this day, I ask, O God. Open our hearts to receive from heaven and our ears to hear your words and our minds to understand what you would say unto your church. We give you all glory, all honor and praise. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Amen. Hallelujah. It says in Romans 8:29, for whom he did foreknow, he also did predestinate to be conformed to the image of his Son, that he might be the firstborn among many brethren. Moreover, whom he did predestinate, them he also called. And whom he called, them he also justified. In whom he justified, them he also glorified. Now, the scripture today is not talking about predestination of the individual, but it is talking about the predestination of the church, about the destiny of those that are in the bride of Christ. If you are a member of the bride of Christ, if you have repented and been baptized in the name of Jesus and been filled with the Holy Ghost and trying to live a righteous and holy lifestyle, he did predestinate you to be called and to be justified, and to be glorified with him in heaven. If you are a member of the bride of Christ, you have this promise within you, and no one can take it from you. No one can remove it from you. But as we look around the world, we see maybe this church is not all it's cracked up to be. Maybe, as I already talked about in the introduction, that maybe there are some things that we are going against, and you know, it's our perception in our minds that maybe we cannot make it through. We see the church anymore as a social club of where we get along with people that we like, but we think that's about the extent of it sometimes. But the church is so much more than that. The church is your refuge of salvation. Your refuge from the world. We have to identify the church today as not just a social club, but it is the bride of Christ. Your means of transformation from the world into glory. Your means of going to heaven. The church is your means of encouragement, of hope, and of love, and experiencing the power of God. The church is so much more than just a building. It's so much more than just a program. It's so much more than just a few people gathered together to sing pretty songs together. It's something powerful that was instituted by God for the benefit of man to be able to be saved. It seems that the church has always had a difficult time through the ages. We've seen persecution. We've seen attacks from different governments, from different religious institutions, attacking the church of the one true God. But it has always survived. It's always survived. And I want to talk to you about a few things the church is going to survive, just for a few moments today. The church has survived through doubts. The very conception of the church began with the resurrection of Jesus Christ. He had taught so much, and everything was coming true with that moment of resurrection. And even though many believed, there was still doubt among the brethren. The very inner circle of Jesus Christ said, you know, this really can't be true. There are some of us who have come today who have been invited, or we just think we have come by happenstance to come into this room and say, this is really nice and all, but I don't know if it's true. I don't know if God can really help me like I've heard he can help me. I don't know if he can really reach down into my problems. That's nothing new, church, I promise you. It's been happening since the very conception of the church. Thomas, one of the disciples of Jesus, he said, you know, unless I put my fingers in his hands and touch my hand to his side, he said, I'm not even going to believe that he resurrected. Thomas was coming from a place of pain because he believed with all his heart at one time. Thomas was the one when Jesus said, let's go to Lazarus. Thomas said, let's go and die with him. Let's go and feel what Jesus feels. Let's go and see what happens. Let's go and let's do whatever Jesus asks us to do. It was whenever Thomas was the one when Jesus said, I'm going to leave you. Thomas said, well, how am I going to find you? He was the one that believed with his whole heart. We believed and desired to follow Jesus in everything. But the moment Jesus was crucified on the cross, his belief seemed to be shattered and broken. And he said, I don't know if I can believe again. It hurts more when you believe more. It hurts more when you trust more. The pain, the reverb of the pain is so much stronger when you've given everything to loving and believing somebody or something. And when you are betrayed, it begins to destroy you. And Thomas was in that moment, and doubt began to spring. He said, if I've been hurt like this, there's no reason for me to keep believing. I can't believe in Jesus anymore. I can't believe in his message anymore. There are people saying here, I don't believe in the love of God anymore. I don't believe in the love of my family anymore. I don't believe in hope. I don't believe in healing. I believe that this is my life because I trusted once and I have been hurt. I've given my all at one point and I have been rejected. And you know what Jesus did to Thomas, for Thomas? I think this is beautiful. He said Jesus came to the door in John 20 and 26. It says Jesus, the door is being shut. Jesus came to the door and stood in the midst and said, peace be unto you. Then said he to Thomas, nobody else, looks at Thomas. He said, reach hither thy finger and behold my hands. Reach hither thy hand and thrust it into my side. And be not faithless, but believing. I believe, church, that Jesus could have resurrected without a scratch. He could have come up from the grave without a mark on his body. But he knew that somebody needed to touch his scars. So he resurrected with the remembrance of the cross and the pain of his crucifixion. And he resurrected so that one man would believe. God is willing to do whatever it takes for you to believe once more. The church is going to survive doubt. It's going to survive pain because Jesus does not want you to be a faithless generation, but he desires for you to live and to love and have life within him. You don't have to walk around with the scars of betrayal. Jesus already did it for you. And he's willing to carry them as long as necessary for you to believe. If you have lost something in your life, Jesus is able to restore it. If you feel that you cannot trust anymore, Jesus is able to be your hope in your trust, because he never fails and he never falters. We cannot be a doubting church, because God does not desire that. Don't come in here with doubt. We have two options. Remember Job and Job's wife? They both had two different reactions to their circumstances. She said, Job cursed God and die. Job said, though he slay me, yet will I trust in him. Can you trust God through the pain, church? Can you love God through the disappointment? Can you love him enough? Thomas still had to wait a few days after the crucifixion, but he still was able to gather together. There are people here in this house that are able to gather with their brothers and sisters, yet they don't have the faith. They don't have the belief. They're just holding on to the pain and the hurt of their life. Hallelujah. Jesus said, be not faithless, but believe. The church is going to survive doubt. The church is going to survive the people that say, I don't believe. We can make it, church. We can make it. The church has survived critics. The first outpouring of the Spirit was met with critics and mocking. There were people that believed that this was just something, a new fad, just people getting drunk on the street. In Acts 2:13, it said these men are full of new wine. They just wanted to mock and they wanted to ridicule. You know, there's some people we're working with back in Russia. Some of them are former Catholics. Some of them are former Assembly of God. And some of these ladies are Filipinos. I don't know if you know much about the Filipino culture, but they're very tight-knit in their culture, and then their families are very close. And these women are getting converted, and they're believing in God, and they're trusting in him. But as soon as they tell their families, they face criticism so deep. One woman, she said, I have some questions for you. I said, well, come on over to the house. We'll have a Bible study. And for the next 3 hours, we were sitting. And halfway through, she said, Pastor, I'm so sorry to keep you. But if you knew what it would be, what it's going to be like when I talk to my family. If you knew what it's like. See, my dad, my dad is a pastor of a different denomination. And he hates people like you. and he's going to hate people like me now. And she said, I'm facing so much criticism from other family members, and he doesn't know yet. So I want to talk to you as much about God as I possibly can, so that whenever he comes as a critic trying to destroy this new belief in me, I have an answer for him. That I can tell him I have an answer and a reason for believing this way. Church, you're always going to have critics, because the flesh does not understand what the Spirit does. The world cannot understand what the Spirit is working in the church. And Peter did something on that day of Pentecost when people were criticizing and ridiculing. There were three things that he did. He said, I stood up. That was the first thing. He didn't cower down. He didn't hide behind everybody else and say, I'm sorry for what I believe, but he said, I'm going to stand up here, and I'm going to give you a target. You know, church, we have got, if we're going to be criticized by the world, let us be criticized for being apostolic Pentecostal. If we're going to be criticized, let us be criticized for speaking in tongues. Let us be criticized for doing things that the Bible says. Let us be criticized for holding on to the doctrines of God. Let's not be criticized because we're half in and half out. Let's not be criticized because we're so embarrassed by what we believe we can never witness or outreach. I'm talking to the church right now. We need to not be embarrassed by our message, because it is our life source and our ability to go to heaven. Let us not be ashamed, but let us stand up so the world can see what we believe and who we are. Then he stood up with the others. A mistake some of us so often make is, as soon as we face criticism, we separate ourselves from the church. We separate ourselves from our brothers and sisters. When somebody says, I don't believe you need to be doing this, well, maybe you're right. Let me come over here. Let me appease you a little bit with a little worldly living. Let me appease you a little bit with a little bit of flesh. Let me separate myself from my brothers and sisters. But Peter didn't do that. He stood up with the brothers. And all of those, he said, he stood up with the other 11. And he said, and then he began to preach. You see, we need our brothers and our sisters in times of criticism. The Bible says, even as you see the day approaching, forsake not the assembling of yourselves together. Don't forsake your brothers and sisters. Whenever you're facing a hard time, we need each other. Don't run out of the church when you're facing criticism, when you're facing hardship and tribulation. Don't run out of the church. That's not where you're going to find salvation. You're just going to conform to be one of your own critics. Stay with the church. Stay with your brothers. Stay with your sisters. The next thing that he did, he spoke. The most powerful thing you can do to your critics is begin to talk to them about God and your experience. Whenever I was about 14 years old in high school, I went to a new school, and it was a missionary school. Every kid there was a missionary's kid, and they knew the Bible backwards and forwards, and they thought they did. I got up there and said, I think my first week of school, said, so what denomination are you? I said, okay, well, I'm Apostolic Pentecostal. They said, well, we've never heard of that. I said, well, I'm not surprised. Well, what makes you so different? I said, well, one of the main things, I said, we baptize in the name of Jesus. You'd have thought I'd have slapped him across the face. I said, you can't do that? I said, well, yeah, you can. You can baptize in Jesus. And I began to show him scriptures. And actually, I took him to Acts 2:38 and said, well, that explains it all. And I was like, if you don't get that, that was foolishness of youth. But for the next years, I debated and I argued and I witnessed and I tried my best to convert. And I was about my junior year of high school. People began to really get fighting and angry. And so the teacher of our Bible class said, okay, we're going to have a debate. Everyone who believes you should be baptized in Jesus' name is on one side. Everyone who believes you should be baptized in the titles on the other side. And we're going to have a debate. It was the whole high school. Well, you can imagine how big my team was. It was just me. And I sat there and I went home. And it's not fun to be the kid picked on in high school, to be the odd one. And I remember, if some of you go into school here, it's okay to not be to be the only apostolic there. I'm sure you're not the only one, but it's okay if you are. You'll survive. You'll make it. I went home and I was real sad and I said, Dad, nobody likes me. What am I going to do? And he said, well, let's look at the Bible. And he said, Jordan, you know why you believe what you believe? I said, well, kinda. I mean, I was only 15, 16. I said, yeah, as much as anyone else my age does. So, well, let's study. Let's study. And I began to read the Bible. I began to seek the Word of God. Any book I could get on doctrine, on the teachings of the Bible, I began to consume and read and read. And I came to that debate prepared, and I began to speak with these people. And every point they would make, the Spirit of God would bring to me another verse, another scripture. And it went on like this for over 2 hours. We would go back and forth. Everyone on the opposite team would stand up, and they would ask me questions. And they would ridicule, and they'd criticize. But every time I could stand up and say, it's in the Word of God. There is only one Lord, one faith, one baptism, one God and Father of all, who is above all, who's in all, who's through all and in you all. I could say the fullness of the Godhead dwelleth in Christ Jesus bodily. And this went on and on and on. And they ended the debate thinking that they would crush me and convert me. And the teacher stood up and said, well, it's a stalemate. He said, the Trinity is a mystery we can never comprehend. And I said, I understand. He said, let's not talk about that now. The debate's over. But a few weeks later, one of those young men came to my house and we were sitting and talking. He said, what is it you believe again? out of the peer pressure, out of everyone else. And he said, I can't believe, after we talked a little bit, he said, I cannot believe in the Trinity anymore. I can't believe in the titles anymore. He said, I can't even pray anymore because it's in my mind that I'm praying to something that is false and not real. Don't think that your witness doesn't have an effect. Though the world stand up against you, the word of God will remain settled and true. This word is real, and it is above every opinion and every voice of man in the world. Hallelujah. The best thing you can do is speak to your critics, because either they will leave you alone or they'll join you. Speak to your critics. Lastly, the church survives bad members. I won't go into too much detail in this, but let me just say, Ananias and Sapphira, when they happened and they lied to the Holy Spirit, I bet there were some people in the back row saying, church is gone. It's done for. Well, they messed up. The church isn't going to last. It's only been a few weeks and people are dropping dead at the altar. We're not going to make it. The church survived that. Church survived that, and God gave revival for it. But I say all this today, and I want you to understand that there is still a church. There's still a church for a purpose. We are not here just to waste time. We are not here to merely wait and do nothing. We have been given a great gift called the church. And we can join in it. And we can be saved. And we can be healed. And we can have all the things we need. But we've got to make it up in our mind that I am going to be a part of the church of the living God. There is healing because there is still a church. There is power because there is still a church. There is hope because there is still a church. There is a place of healing and help in your time of trouble because there is still a church. Do not ever leave this church. Do not ever leave the teachings of the church because there's still a church. Hallelujah. Bless the Lord. Let's praise Him today. Hallelujah. Thank you, God. Thank you, God. Thank you, God. In the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. Oh, hallelujah. Hallelujah. Seek Him for a few moments, church, please. I'm closing very quickly. Just don't rush through this. Oh, Jesus. I know we have expectation today, but let's not let our expectation run ahead of the presence of God. Oh, God, speak to us. Hallelujah, Jesus. Bless the Lord, bless the Lord, bless the Lord. Bless the Lord, Jesus. Hallelujah. 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 I'm not worried about the church. It's always going to be. The gates of hell will not prevail against the church. That's a promise. We're going to be justified and glorified because we're called into His church. But I worry at times, oh Jesus, I worry about the times when the members say, I find this to be just normal. This isn't in my notes. I'm putting those away. When we come to this place and say, this is just average. This is just way we do things. This is, I get worried whenever church becomes casual in the minds of its people. I don't know if this is for you today, church, but never let this service become a casual experience. Never allow the moving of the Spirit to say, well, we did that, let's move on, let's go. But let it be something that empowers you, something that allows you to go to another level in Him. I feel this is the word of God to the church today. There's still a church. Don't get worried. The attacks of the enemy, don't get worried. Just keep on doing the things that are in the word of God, and you will overcome. Stand with me. Stand with me, please. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Hallelujah, Jesus. Oh, bless the Lord. Bless the Lord. Bless the Lord. God's willing to do a lot for the church. If Thomas would have never had his belief restored, he would never have stayed, and a portion of the church would have never been built. If Peter would not have stood with the other 12, doubts and fear would have clouded their minds, and they would have doubted their experience. If one apostle would have just said, well, Ananias and Sapphira, good-meaning people, and allowed sin into the church, a generation would have been lost. But your strength and your hope today, I can promise you this, is no great secret. It's to stay together as a church. If you are hurting today, gather with these people here. Pray with them. It's no great secret. It's no special power, but the power of God and the power of His church. If you're hurting and you need a touch of God, there's an altar. That's what the church is for. If your family's going through something, there's no better place to restore it but right here in the church. Because we love you. We want to pray with you. And when two or three are gathered in the name of Jesus, He's there as well. And we're sitting here, and some of us are in different stages of our walk with God. Some of us has walked with a long time and never got serious. Some of us are very fresh and new, and we still have a lot of scars and baggage. Doesn't matter. This is the church. That's what it's here for. Doesn't matter where you're at. Doesn't matter if you feel that I'm getting ready to walk away from this. This could be the last service that you have given a chance to God to. Doesn't matter. This is the church. And God is always ready. He's always ready to touch. Always ready to meet the needs of His people. That's why I'm preaching this to you today. You found healing in the church before. You felt hope in the church before. You're going to find it again, because there's still a church. There's still a church that preaches truth. There's still a church that loves you. There's still a church that wants to help you. There's still brothers and sisters that are going to reach out to you when you're hurting and in need, when you're broken. There's still a church. And it's going to survive every attack. Oh, hallelujah. That's it, church. Let's create an atmosphere for the Lord to work. Let's do what we were made to do. Let's worship Him. Let's glorify Him. Hallelujah. Come on. Yes, church. You're not a novice in this. This isn't something new to you. Let's create a new spirit in the house. A fresh anointing from God. An atmosphere where He can touch. Hallelujah. Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Hallelujah. whoever has a need in here today, this is the atmosphere where you can be reached. This is the atmosphere that God has prepared for you. He's prepared what it takes today for your doubts to be made vanished. He's done what it takes today for you to be healed. He's done what it takes for you to be forgiven. He's done what it takes for you to be restored. He's done it all for you in this moment right now. Now it is up to you. Will you be in the church? Will you come into His presence saying, God, recreate in me a new heart. Make me what you want me to be. Take my problems, take my failures, God, and make something new in me. This is the atmosphere. This is the church. This is the moment. Would you come today, church? Would you pray? Everybody who can, begin to come forward. Begin to come up. Don't wait around. Come on, let's just come up. There's an atmosphere here for God to move and to work in your life. Hallelujah. Yes. In the name of Jesus, look upon your people this day. Lord, for your own glory to be fulfilled, oh Lord. Confirm your word in these people. Confirm your word in this church, oh God. In every heart and in every life, oh God.
I am the thorn in your crown, but you will love me anyway. And I am the sweat from your brow,
but you love me anyway.
And I am the nail in your wrist,
but you love me anyway.
And I am Judas's kiss, but you love me. Called out from the crowd for your blood to be spilled on this earth-shaking ground. Yes, then I turned away with this smile on my face, with this sin in my heart, tried to bury your grace. And then alone in the night, I still called out for you, so ashamed.
Yes, you love me anyway.
Oh,
Lord.
Can I tell you what I feel, church, today? God is saying, I want to do something special right now. But there is a wall. There is a wall that is up. There is a wall that is up. Perhaps it's the wall of hurt and pain that Brother Jordan was talking about today. Perhaps it's the wall of scars. Perhaps it's the wall that if I do this, God, what are you going to require of me? Can I tell you right now that God has never called anyone to do something without parting the sea for you to walk through it. God doesn't crack doors. He opens doors for your life. So right now, all across the sanctuary, if y'all could stand, if you've got strength and to stand and you're able to, I want everyone in this congregation to lift up both hands to heaven and with one voice and one cry right now to this generation, I want to challenge you right now with your praise and your worship as your hands are extended right now. I'm going to ask you to do something right now that's going to be inconvenient. It's going to be vulnerable. But let me tell you right now, if you could just lift up your hands and your head and begin to say, God, I'm going to take down the wall, Lord. And God, I want you to know, Lord, I want you to do something special in my life, God. I want you to do something special, God, in my family. I want you to do something special in my home. I need for you to do something special in my mind. Lord God, I want you, God, to do something great, God, in my life. God, Lord, I know, God, there's no way around it, but I'm going to have faith, God, and believe, Lord, that you love me, that you care for me. You love me so much that you died for me, and you love me, Jesus. Lord, God, I want you to bless me. I want you to help me, Lord. God, I submit to you.
I am the nail in your wrist.
Come on, a little bit deeper now, a little bit deeper. A little bit deeper now. Come on, take another brick down. Take another block down. Take another brick down. Jesus' name, Lord. Hallelujah, God. Oh, Lord, bless it, Lord, God. Yes, Jesus. I submit to you, Lord. Satan's been trying to kill me, but God, it's running to me. It found me. When I didn't want it to, it found me. Oh, God. Lord, no one's loved me like that before. No one's cared for me like that before. Compared to it, that you love me, yes, Lord. Oh, Lord, how you love me, Jesus, but you love me. It's like nothing, Lord. Oh, oh, oh.
But you love me anyway.
Oh, Lord, how you love me, Lord. This.
But you love me anyway.
Do you believe that tonight?
Like nothing in life
that I've ever known.
I've ever known.
But
yes,
you love me anyway.
Oh Lord, how you love me.
Hallelujah, Jesus. Hallelujah, Jesus. We praise you, Jesus. Lifting you up, Jesus. Hallelujah, Lord God. Praise you, praise you, praise you, praise you, praise you, praising you, praising you. One more time, could you love Jesus right now in your own way? Just love him. Thank you. all across this sanctuary today. What our missionary was talking about today is so powerful. If you're in this house today, be remiss if I did not extend this. If you're in this house today, and if you've not been baptized in the name of Jesus Christ today, and God's been dealing with your heart, God's been dealing with your heart. You say, Pastor, I've already repented my sins. I feel like there's something more that I need to get a hold of. You're right. You're right. Because after repentance, God said, I'm going to establish to be baptized in me. We baptize in the name of Jesus Christ today. And the Bible says that God will, he shall fill you with the gift of the Holy Ghost. In this house that you've not been baptized, we've got waters, we've got robes, we've got everything you need right now. The only thing you must possess is a willing and a made up heart and mind. And God will bless you today. Hallelujah. Haven't we heard from heaven today? We heard from heaven today. Hallelujah. Let's thank God for what we heard today. Hallelujah. I praise you. Praise God. There's a lingering spirit here today. We thank God for what he's going to do today in this house. We give God praise. Jesus, thank you for what we've heard today, God. You have spoken to us. You've spoken to your church, God. Thankful to know and confident to know that, God, Lord, the gates of hell shall not prevail against your church. And God, we know where to run to. God, when we need that protection and that providing power, that safety net, God, that you provide for your people today, God, I thank you for the church. Thank you for the church, God, that Brother Joel was talking about today. We give you praise, glory, and honor, God, and we are leaving this place with the encouragement, God, to know, God, that there's still a church, God, that you've got, and God, one day you're going to rapture your church, and you're going to call us home, Jesus. God, we can't wait till that day. Can't wait till that moment, God, when you call us home today, Jesus. Bless us, Lord. Bless us as we leave this place and go to our place that we are desiring. We praise you in the name of Jesus, we pray. Everyone said in Jesus' name, I want you to shake someone's hand and hug a neck. Amen. Lord bless you real good. Let our evangelist know what a great job he did as well. Lord bless you.